Hey guys, welcome. If you are new to the channel, I'm Meg. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. I wanted to do a tag video and I saw Angelica Nyquist. I don't know if I'm saying your name correctly. I'm sorry if I'm butchering your last name. But she did the My Makeup Habits tag about 3 days ago as I'm filming this. So I thought, why don't I do that tag as well? And if you don't follow Angelica, I'm going to link her channel down below so you can go ahead and do that. She's a Swedish YouTuber that I am a very big fan of at the moment. I like how she's like talking about makeup and how she's not afraid of color, where I've seen a lot of YouTubers who are afraid of color. Anyways, in fact, she is an inspiration for the eye look that I have now because I'm like, why don't I use my colors? So there you go. So let's get on with this. The first question is, how often do you wear a full face of makeup? Foundation, eyeshadow, contour, the works. Pretty much every day, whenever I go to work. I do it so lightly though. I normally stick with neutral colors at work. I don't wear this heavy of a makeup. And I also use a lighter coverage foundation, or actually it's not a foundation, it's the It Cosmetics CC cream. So yeah, but I do like that, but I do wear a full face of makeup whenever I go to work. The only thing that I don't do is put on lashes because that's a little bit extra, I have to say, for the kind of work that I do. Is your everyday makeup look more neutral or more colorful? I think I've answered that in the previous question, which is that I stick to a more neutral tone because I do work in a corporate environment, and loud colors aren't really as appreciated as if I were working in a creative field, you know. How long does it take you to do your go-to makeup look? I would say about 15 minutes, the whole thing. It doesn't really take me that long with my signature look. I don't really have a signature look per se, but I usually stick with like two eyeshadow colors, and that's pretty much it. Next, do you apply your foundation before or after you've done your eyeshadow? It depends. If I know that the eyeshadow has a lot of fallout, and I know this because I have a smaller collection now and I've used all my eyeshadow, so I know whether they're gonna have fallout, if they're gonna be powdery or whatever, and I always try to tap before I put them on my face anyways. So if I know that it's gonna have a massive fallout, or if it's like pretty colorful like this one that might have fallout, then I do my eyes first and then foundation later. Otherwise, if it's like a one shadow or a two shadow look that I know is gonna be pretty neutral, then I just go with foundation first. Number five, what are some bad makeup habits you have that you can't stop doing? I should have read these questions first because I really have no idea. Define bad makeup habits. I wash my beauty blender every time before I use it. I deep wash my brushes every week, so I don't know what kind of bad habit I probably would have. I don't think I have any. Do you use beauty influencer techniques or your own techniques to apply your makeup? Look, I'll be honest with you, I didn't know how to put on makeup until I started watching YouTube back in 2009. I had no idea. I was like 28, 29 at the time and didn't wear makeup at all. So yeah, I've learned everything that I know based off of YouTubers that I've watched, as well as I actually went to train to be a makeup artist, like more for bridal looks, which is why I did my own makeup at my wedding. I did learn a lot of techniques from beauty influencers, but I also learned a lot from my teacher in makeup school. Okay. What is the one step in your makeup routine that takes the longest to complete? I would say it's always the eyeshadow, because one, I could never decide on what shades to put together, and plus with all the blending that needs to happen, that is usually the most difficult, or not really the most difficult, but the most time consuming. All right. Number 8A. Oh, Two questions in one. What is the one step in your makeup routine that you're okay with skipping? Primer. I usually skip face primer. I never skip eyeshadow primer because I've got really super duper oily lids, so I can't be without an eye primer. But face primer, I can definitely go without. What is the one step in your makeup routine you will never skip? Oh, there you go. I answered that question as well. Eyeshadow primer, I'll never skip that. I always wear that. Even when I'm just putting on makeup to film and then taking the makeup off, because I just feel like the eyeshadows appear better when there's primer underneath. Number 9, what type of makeup looks are out of your comfort zone? I can't really do like cosplay stuff or Halloween makeup because I'm not very creative in that sense. Like, this is pretty much out of my comfort zone already. So yeah, Halloween makeup that requires special effects, I've never learned how to do it. I've always wanted to, but it's just, yeah, that's out of my comfort zone. Number 10, do you wear matte liquid lipstick, cream lipstick, gloss, or a mixture? I wear all of them. Sometimes, I'm not really a gloss person. I never was, even when I was younger, because it just annoys me when my hair sticks to it. So now, like, the market is being saturated with glosses, and it's not really something that I am a fan of. In fact, I've had my NARS lip gloss Super Vixen for, it's time for it to actually go. But yeah, it's just I don't wear it. I don't wear it at all. Number 11, if you could only wear one shade of lipstick for the rest of your life, what would it be? Well, actually, these two lipsticks have the same shade, so I think it's okay. One for liquid lipstick, matte, would be the Dose of Colors Truffle, which is the same shade, pretty much the same shade as the one that I'm wearing now, which is the NARS Audacious Lipstick in Vanessa. These, I think, are my perfect nude shades, and I could pair them with anything. 12, do you highlight and contour your face? I did today. I don't know if you can actually see it, but I did today. I usually do, but on a daily basis, I use a bronzer more for like contouring as opposed to a proper contour palette like my Lorac Pro Contour Palette, because I think it's just subtler when I use a bronzer. And finally, what is the one step in your makeup routine that makes you feel the most complete? Eyelashes. If I don't put on false lashes, me having super sparse, short, straight Asian lashes, it just doesn't look right. So I always have to put on eyelashes if I want my makeup look to look, you know, on point, on fleek. Yeah, so those were the 13 questions out of the Makeup Habits Tag questions. I am tagging Liv Loves Her Makeup. I'm tagging Makeup by Amy Michelle. I'm tagging Tiffany. What does she call herself now? I forget. Tiffany D. Makeup or Loves Her Makeup. Anyway, I'm going to link all of them down below. I am also tagging Mr. Ken Dennis. Tagging Just Buy the Makeup and Kitschnitch from the Beauty News ladies, as well as Aussie Beauty Talk. So I'm tagging all you guys to do this makeup tag. There you go. And what else? Oh, I also want to tag Shara Sumabat and Yellow Yum and Rachel. And who else do I want to tag? Yeah. Those people. I want to tag those people. I'm going to list down below the persons that I'm tagging, or probably in this video at the end anyways. If you like this video, do give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, and click on that bell icon so you are notified of my videos. I upload at least 3 times a week, sometimes more than that. I know that in the past week or two, I've been uploading almost every day. Comment down below your answers to these questions, or if you are making a video out of this tag, then please leave me a link or something for me to be able to watch it, or just comment that you've done it so I'll go ahead and check it out. All right, Thanks always for your support, and I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye!